Yes! Star Hopper, finally, with a big hop. We're talking about that coming up. Hey guys, Tori here from Overlook Horizon. If you're new to the channel, we fly high altitude weather balloon flights to the edge of space and back, and along the way we talk about space, science, and technology. So if that's something you're interested in, consider subscribing. Today we're talking again about the big headline for the past couple of weeks, which is the SpaceX Starhopper, because it finally completed its big hop. Now if you're just coming up to speed, the Starhopper is the first step in the development of SpaceX's much larger Starship and Super Heavy rockets. You may have previously heard this referred to as the BFR, or the Big Falcon Rocket. Prior to the most recent flight, the FAA had granted SpaceX the ability to complete unlimited flight tests to an altitude of up to 25 meters. And they have utilized that flight permit to perform three flight tests so far. Two of them were pretty small, just a couple of centimeters off the ground, and one was a little bit larger at 59 feet or 18 meters. For the past couple of weeks, we've been waiting for SpaceX to complete the much larger 200 meter test, although the waiting dragged on while SpaceX and the FAA tried to come to an agreement on what the safety parameters would be so that the FAA could issue SpaceX a safety approval. So the FAA finally did issue SpaceX authorization to perform one much larger hop, and only one much larger hop. This really isn't much of a big deal because Elon Musk has stated many times in the past that this would be the final flight test for the Starhopper platform anyways. After this, SpaceX is intending to move on to their much larger orbital prototype for the Starship rockets, and the Starhopper platform will be converted into a vertical test stand for their new Raptor engines. This flight was allowed to hold up to 30 metric tons of fuel, and it was permitted to fly to an altitude of 150 meters, which is just shy of 500 feet. Now, originally this flight was billed as a 200 meter flight test, or about 650 feet, but it appears that the FAA wanted to put a little bit of a cap on that, presumably for public safety reasons. Don't forget that the Boca Chica launch site down in Texas is only about 1.5 miles or 2.5 kilometers away from the nearest town. For comparison, when I attended my two NASA socials down in Cape Canaveral, Florida, we had prime viewing area, which was still about 2.9 miles or a little less than 5 kilometers away from the launch site, and that was as close as anybody could get. So there are residents and houses that are less than half the distance that I was allowed to go at, and they are not completely clear of all risks. So much so that local authorities down in Boca Chica Village handed out flyers to their residents urging them to stay out of their houses for fear that an overpressure failure event could break their windows and blow glass into their houses. Now, when it came to the test flight itself, it wasn't without drama. The first flight attempt came later that day on Monday, August 26th, but it was aborted just 0.8 seconds after ignition when, well, ignition didn't happen. You see, Elon Musk mentioned on Twitter that the igniters that actually do the igniting of the Raptor engines didn't actually ignite. The new Raptor engines that SpaceX is developing for their new Starship and Super Heavy rockets not only uses a new fuel mixture, but it also uses a new, or rather just a different, ignition process. You may be familiar with the Falcon 9 rocket, which uses a pyrophoric chemical ignition process made up of the chemicals triethyl aluminum and triethyl borane, or TTAB. This is the iconic green flash that we see at the engine bells when the first and second stages of the Falcon 9 ignite, and the TTAB instantly combusts with oxygen and ignites the engine. The Raptor engine, however, uses methane and a spark plug igniter system. A spark plug ignites a little blowtorch, and that in turn ignites the main combustion chamber. And it appears that those spark plugs didn't actually operate. We did see cryogenic fuel pouring out of the engine bell, but no ignition whatsoever, and the test was promptly aborted. The actual flight itself took place on Tuesday, August 27th, the very next day, and it was amazing. Way better than I expected it to be. That awkward little flying water tower with legs lifted off, traveled to an altitude of about 150 meters or a little less than 500 feet, added in a roll program before it finally had a soft landing on the adjacent landing pad just a few meters away. The test itself seems to be a major success for SpaceX, but it wasn't perfect. You see, we did see a composite overwrap pressure vessel, or COPV, liberate itself from the Starhopper, and it landed a little ways away just after landing. That's not supposed to happen, but it's really a non-issue because for this test to be successful, it really just needed to launch and land from point A to point B, mostly in one piece. So this appears to give SpaceX the green light to move on to the next stage of development, which is the orbital prototype for Starship. That much larger prototype could be flying as early as a month or two from now, and will start with some suborbital flights before moving on to actual orbital test flights. So, question of the day, how insane was that test flight? Are we living in the future, or was this just a crazy flying water tower? Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. As always, thanks to our Patreon supporters for making videos like this possible. If you like this kind of content, please like the video and consider subscribing so you don't miss any of our SpaceX live streams. All right, thanks everybody for watching. We'll see you in the next video.